Street selected Florida State as one of his finalists this year, and they are on a roll.
They're going to be a heck of a challenge. I mean, they'll be one of the, if not the best, one of the best offenses we'll play all year.
Look like the typical Florida State teams that I've seen in past years.
They stack three wide to the left. The Tars throws underneath to Hopkins, and the Noles were ready. That's O'Leary, the tight end, looking like an H-back. And Manuel's going to put it up on first down. Complete for a big first down. Rodney Smith.
How they play here early in this game.
Now Pryor checks in on this first down. He'll lead the way for Chris Thompson. Watch the fullback. He'll take you to the action. And Thompson to the 40. Kirby here on second down. Play action. Manuel pops it off to O'Leary for the first down. 45-yard line, and it's first down the Noles. Two before the night's over. Here he is coming around behind Thompson, keeping it all the way. 30, 25, 20, 15, and out of bounds, far side. He is so dangerous on the move.
He is a dangerous threat. Watch the seal block on the outside. O'Leary, who just made a nice catch, now he's blocking. Thompson's out front. He's helping out. Also, Rodney Smith doing a good job. When you get receivers blocking downfield, it helps out. Love to see Chris Thompson getting involved. Not just running the football, but being willing to block.
Safety was pressing in the box. They're going to try to blitz the run, and it's Pryor again. Touchdown, Florida State.
I want you to watch the quarterback here, E.J. Manuel. This is what I'm talking about. He recognizes the safety, extra run support. So he's going to see he's moving the play over to the left, a stretch play to the left. What I think this play has become the bread and butter for this Florida State team. You can see the stretch here, the nice block here on the linebacker, and it gives him a nice fire, a nice seam to be able to cut inside there. Patience is key from the running back. That play takes time. Once you see it, you got to hit it in a hurry. And Pryor's a fullback. He did a really nice job there of leading. And
Noles need to get to the 27-yard line for a first down. E.J. is going to keep it, and he'll run for the first down. Slides down at the 39-yard line.
So he a wrinkle to add to their repertoire.
Straight back, in trouble. Down at the 48-yard line. Let's check in down the middle. That's the Tigers do. Play action, in trouble. Sack back at the 40-yard line by Carradine.
Protection. That's the concern, the matchup right here on the outside. A little confusion because of the twist. He stepped down, leaving Carradine. Tonight, they've been a little bit more shotgun, looking for matchups to be able to throw the ball.
They're going to run Thompson. Quick cutback, look out! He's got great speed! And he's finally taken out of bounds by Jonathan Meeks. He was the last man who could have stopped him.
Well, watch this stutter step. I'm not comparing him to Reggie Bush, but the way he accelerates with his jump cuts, like a LaMichael James type of guy. Boom, 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 right there. I mean, you don't see most backs with the ability to bounce like that and then accelerate in the middle of the process of the cut.
He went for a 74 and 80-yard touch. They need 15, remember, after that penalty. Ride Thompson, E.J. back, come middle, O'Leary. O'Leary to the 5-yard line. That'll bring a smile to the Golden Bear.
They see the guard, Matias, pulling. You see the back. There's a lot of action in the background. So the linebackers see this movement. They step up. Nice job of waiting to find the window. He had to get the ball thrown over top of Willard, who didn't quite commit to the play-action fake. But a lot of movement in front of the linebackers froze.
Fire is there. James Wilder, the big back, is behind Pryor. Pryor leads the way. Wilder steps to the right. Wilder, touchdown! James Wilder. Here we are tied at 14. First down and 10. Tyus Boyd keeps it himself. Got a couple of yards, and there's a player who is down. That's Warner with the helmet coming off. He's Boyd in trouble, scrambles out of it on the move. And he had to throw that one away. Mark Green in motion for the Noles. And they're going to fire it to him on that quick screen. And he is out to the 41, trying to make two touchdowns. And he's going to put it up for the 15th time tonight. Has to throw it away. In trouble from his second down and four. And Ellington is short of the first down. Third down and four here, Robert. Manuel drops it off to Thompson. Got the first down for the Noles and out of bounds. Manuel back into the pocket. Swings it on out to Thompson. They got a lot of running room. 35. Tight rope and finally out of bounds. But he's at the 23-yard line where he finally was pushed out.
Perfect time to call this by Jimbo Fisher. They brought the linebackers. Manuel waited. He baited them and waited and then dumps it down to Thompson, who has three blockers downfield. And he gets huge yards, gets him well into field goal range here with a minute 14.
It was very close. Seven man coverage. DJ looking downfield. And first down. Snapped it off beautifully.
Here's the football again.
Five wide. Screen to Watkins. Jammed at the point of attack. Emmanuel. Down by two touchdowns now. Jet sweep around. And Benjamin cuts to a hole. Benjamin breaks free. The youngster racing for the end zone. Down by the 10-yard line. Willard saves a touchdown for Kelvin Benjamin.
Watch Cameron Irvin get downfield. The left tackle blocking. They'll be able to spring him loose. The receivers also really good job of blocking by Green. And then there's speed. Look at this guy. He's 6'5", 242 pounds, running down the sidelines. And eventually Clemson barely catches up to him.
Back to the 26-yard line. They were at the 11. Manuel keeps it.
Thinking about, I'm going to throw it out in the flat, possibly try to find the fullback. This is a design run. Turn the corner, the defense is committed down, and he...
hard line, and that's important because it becomes second down at eight. Option, pitch, Thompson, end zone, got seven right back if they had the extra point.
Defensive end, commit to him. Make sure he can't make the tackle on the back. He locks in on Manuel. Manuel flips it out there, and of course, there's Lonnie Pryor leading the way with another block and a touchdown. They're executing.
Short drop knocked away. Great defense on the corner over there that time, and that was Wason. Watkins out of the backfield. Taj Boyd backs up. Wants to go downfield. Safety valve with Watkins. Incomplete. And
here we go now. Spencer Benton will kick this off. And it'll be fielded at the one by Junior. He's been to kickoff return, and he's got an alley. Coming to the near side, 35, 40, breaks it. He's got one man to beat. Can he split him? And he's wrestled down at the 11-yard line. Junior.
What an effort here. And a perfect time for a big return. The fullback who's in there, Chad Abram, does a good job. But really, this is just Joyner being an athlete out in space. These are all the years he played backyard football. He gets a nice job of setting up the kicker. And then down the sideline, I thought he might have the speed to take it all the way into the end zone. But Clemson finally catches up to him.
Thompson, the running back. Play action. Throws high. Touchdown!
The backs are going to cross. Here comes a blitz to the outside. Watch what happens here. The job that Lonnie Pryor does, the fullbacks are being able to pick this up. Blanks comes in. They pick it up. It's a slant move, and then back to the outside. And Breland did not have a chance, but it was activity in the backfield. The defense is peeking into that and seeing the play action, and a beautiful move there to the outside, and Green is left all alone for the touchdown.
Top of your screen. Press coverage, so Boyd comes down to the bottom. To the 26-yard line, and Tyler Hunter making the play defensively. And throws too deep with his safeties, and he backs him off again. Fires middle, incomplete. Watkins, the intended receiver.
He's 6'4", 232 pounds, running down the middle of the defense. He's got great size, and it's not pass interference there at all.
And a couple of guys are holding up the towels down there. Manuel snaps it off, complete. Remember, DJ can hurt you on the move. Same point.
There goes. Just snapped it to Kenny Shaw, the junior from Orlando, for the first down. So at 16, starts at center. Snaps it to Manuel. Wilder releases. He's a good receiver. Underneath with the throw to the 31-yard line.
Right now, Brent Venables is just sinking back. He did this a lot in the first half, keeping everything in front of him. They don't want to give up the big play, so Manuel sees that. There's nobody open downfield, so he comes underneath to a shorter receiver.
Thompson will check back in. Cuts into the middle.
Waiting on the umpire.
Second down and one. Here's Thompson again. Power breaks free. Still going. Touchdown! Florida State leads. Chris Thompson would not be denied. James Wilder still in. Long strike. Far side. Touchdown! Rodney Smith interfered with it all. And the Noles lead for the first time tonight.
He has matched up outside Rodney Smith against Darius Robinson, who's 5'10". But the ball is just perfectly thrown. He didn't even have to use his size advantage. He's in rhythm, puts the ball up, and right, if you're just throwing it right up and over. It's like you practice that when you throw it into a bucket. Puts it right where it needs to be. And this big, tall receiver, he separated right at the right time there to get that touchdown.
Third down now. First down. No, incomplete. Wave it off. Hopkins the target. Rhodes a fine corner.
Great coverage, and this is a matchup we all want to see. Rhodes against Hopkins. The ball's thrown actually behind Hopkins. He got to the inside. He beat his man. One of the few throws we've seen from Boyd behind the receiver.
James Wilder. Bigger, stronger back. Checks in behind Pryor. Pryor got him. Breaks free. Spins loose. Wilder crosses. Battles carries three with him. That, folks, is why he was one of the most highly recruited running backs in Florida in the last few years.
You just called for power. You say he's a power back. I think this pretty much tells the story. One tackle, two. And now we're going to bring about three or four with us all the way down to about the 9-yard line. What an effort there by the young sophomore.
35 yards and some punishment. He's coming, and his teammates are going to congratulate him on his sideline. What a greeting he's getting.
Oh, put the helmet right on the ball, secured the football.
This is dish it out.
Does it go down?
Big boy football.
Little stiff arm. He did everything on one carry.
Wilder. He deserves the touchdown, and he gets it. James Wilder barges in. Or lead the way, seal it off. Not much of a hole, but Wilder does the rest. Get out of the backfield, ties Boyd with an empty look, and not much doing. Second and a bunch.
Time to try to respond to it.
In trouble. Ellington catches it for a loss.
Down to pin their ears back and just play much more aggressively up front. A little stunt up there. But you see Warner getting in. He gets a hand on the ball. The linebackers, the coverage, I think, is also tighter. They're not
injured tonight and still coming on every snap. Ties Boyd on a run. Has to throw this away. And Clemson forced a punt again. Suddenly, they cannot get first downs. It's three consecutive three and outs. In complete control, Manuel flares it out to the outside. And the young man, Greg Dent, finally ripped down on that far side near midfield. Bobbles a snap, picks it up, fires to the side, got Dent on a completion, broken play, and Dent battles his way to the 37, and we go to the defense. Washington underneath, and Wilder finally pushed out of bounds just shy of the 20-yard line. Motion, here it comes finally. Watkins on the jet sweep. And ready for it was Warner from Berlin.
Keep in mind that Warner's taking on a blocker and then has to have the speed to get out there. The man on the outside there came to the inside.
Boyd looking for a deep man. Couldn't find him. Throws. Intercepted. Picked off.
the 30. Watkins tries to rip it out. There's a penalty flag. Waysom, who's had a heck of a game.
Boyd getting patient and forced to football. This is reminiscent to late in the year last year. Instead of just trying to take off and pick up some yards, that play didn't have a chance. And, you know, he's down late in the ball game. He's trying to make something happen. But if Waysom didn't come up with that interception, there's a pretty good chance that LaMarcus Joyner would have.
Chris Thompson is the running back. Pryor, the fullback for EJ. 80 yards passing. Hands to Thompson. Daylight on the left side. Sustained. End zone ahead. The killer. The Noles are for real. 27 yards.
Options given in.
Boyd back comes down the middle. Incomplete.
Jones just at the end gets his left hand in there to knock the ball away from Humphreys.
When you play too deep, folks, you got to have a linebacker who can buzz that deep middle. As long as they stay unbeaten, no question about that. Oklahoma will drop out of it for the time being. There he goes. There goes Manuel. Come on, EJ.
It matters. Let's talk about
Jimbo. Congratulations. How on earth did you guys orchestrate that offensive explosion in the second half?
Our kids and our coaches, our assistant coaches did a tremendous job of getting our guys ready at halftime. Our kids, there's a lot of character in these kids. There's a lot of heart. We got a great group of kids, and I'm blessed to be able to coach those guys and coach with those guys.
And it wasn't easy for the first three quarters. You didn't take a lead till late in the third quarter. How did you keep this team believing?
Well, I think we've been through this situation a little bit last year, and we told ourselves we knew it was going to be tough. Things you remember in life are always tough. You got to keep fighting. That's the way we practice. That's the way we play. It's the way we think.
How can a win like this make you guys continue to believe and keep that momentum going?
Well, I think it builds confidence. But right now, what we got to do is enjoy this one, then forget it, get ready for a great South Florida team next week.
Fans certainly enjoyed it as well with Firecrackers. Thanks so much, Coach.